Seth, can you see me like I'm seeing myself right now? Can you see like below my chin?
Yeah, we're a little bit wider than just your head, yeah.
I'll be right back. I
Okay.
forgot something on the stove.
Please welcome to Basket of Wigs.
Yes!
So we had a friend, dear friend of ours, James Anderson, a writer on SNL. He always had a basket of wigs in his office.
God bless.
And what would happen? You're just gonna grab a wig at random. You can grab glasses here if you want,
Thank
and you're
you.
Gonna let it just create a character.
By the way, this is something that would have happened without an audience.
Oh
up
yeah.
In James's office. All yeah. right, I'm gonna go through the basket of wigs. Well, I guess I'll start at the top. Here we go. That makes sense.
Yeah.
It also looks like one of those. This looks like one of those. Things you get at a baseball game that's like the player's hair on
oh,
top
yeah.
of your hair. Maybe that makes more sense.
Yeah.
Seth, where's my breakfast?
Do you need your glasses? They're right in front of you.
Oh, what? Thank goodness. I'm so hungry. Why won't you feed me my breakfast?
Grandma, your breakfast has been out all morning. It's the eggs that you asked for.
I can't remember a thing.
Okay, that's great.
Wow.
I like that.
This
that was really
is,
good.
This game is sending me to wig heaven.
Right.
Well, I want you to pick one.
All right, I'm going to pick one. I'm going to do this. There. No glasses.
I can't wait to see, like, Hugh Jackman do this segment
yeah,
when he
yeah,
comes. And all the
Where's
Trumps.
My prefix?
Guys, I just need to tell you something. Someone threw up in the hallway. There's a lot of vomit. In the hallway, and I'm not cleaning it up. So whoever's responsible, it's gonna have to go home.
That's great.
Thank
I
you.
I really like that character. Very.
Wow. Sadly, I feel like I've worn this wig before.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely have.
Yeah.
I can't keep trying to check out the monitor like it's a mirror. Don't forget my number. Nobody remembers Millie Vanilli, just me.
Okay.
Basket of wigs, going real good.
Basket of wigs.
Coming to you live from Seth Meyers. Wow.
First date.
I just want to be clear on your Tinder. It said you like breath mints, but you don't like to eat them.
I like to keep them in my mouth until they dissolve.
Joshua, that's the most fascinating thing about you.
And is it true that you're a model for the people who make mannequins?
Yes, they use my body as the shape and my face. For the inspiration.
Basket of wigs, everyone! As you know, we're talking backstage. I've got a baby boy.
Ash, baby Ash.
3 months old. And when Amy Poehler had her baby, you and Keenan, you performed on Update as two of my favorite all-time characters, TT and Mario.
They are two of your all-time favorite characters, I know that.
And they're soul singers. They're sort of Ashford and Simpson-y 70s soul singers.
Yeah, they're soul singers, and they love each other very much.
They like to make a lot of love.
And then they sing about it.
And you guys sang a song for Amy's baby.
Yeah, because I wasn't on the show anymore, but I flew out to do a Bronx beat with her, and then she went into labor that night. So for your Update, Keenan and I got to serenade her in the
you
hospital.
You came out, and that was, she
Baby
watched
Archie.
That in the hospital while you guys sang about her baby. And
that
now, is it true that you're gonna, that's me right there. Is it true that we're gonna get a little TT and Mario here for Ash now?
Well, I kind of feel like since it's your favorite, it's gonna be Ash's favorite.
Yeah, I think so too.
So yeah, we have a baby gift for you.
Okay, great.
TT and Mario have a baby gift for you,
okay,
actually.
Great. I'm so happy.
Here it is. Now I'm gonna duck down to put it on. There we go. Okay. And I'm gonna bring my good friend Mario out.
Okay, great.
AKA Keenan Thompson.
Woo!
So much chest hair.
Thank you very much. Nice to see you, Seth.
Nice to see you.
Oh, baby, baby, I love your kiss. No one could ever make me feel like this.
First time I saw your areolas, it was a minute ago, and they were delightful.
I held your booty, and the booty was so tight, singing, booty so right.
Now, the only thing I'd say about that song is it does not seem to be about Ash in any way.
That might be true.
Interesting.
Well, you know what? We do have another baby song that we did for, it was the love theme to the movie Scientific Explosion.
Yeah, this is a baby song.
Okay. Yeah, this is for babies and how you make them.
Look at this miracle.
Just look at what our love has created. Even if you ain't the Jewish type, snip the tip. That's for you, baby Ash.
Maya Rudolph, snip the tip. It's not up to him.
You better tell him.
Snip the tip.
Snip the tip.
Maya Rudolph, everybody, and also Keenan Thompson. You have a wonderful Melania Trump impression, but you have a take on Ivanka Trump.
Well, I've been noticing, actually, our good friend Amy Poehler was the one that pointed it out to me lately. She sent one of her many interviews where she was talking about something. Oh, it was when she said she wasn't involved in, she doesn't get involved in politics.
Yeah, Ivanka.
Because that makes sense.
Yeah, she's not involved in politics.
No, well, they're politics.
Yeah.
Because that makes sense, too. Yeah. Like, you're an advisor to the president.
But not into politics.
We get it. Yeah. We get it. But she pointed out, she was like, there's a lot of whispering going on. And so I noticed, like, she was like, through her teeth, that she, like, kind of talks like she has a sexy secret. She's, like, always talking like she works in a lingerie store a little bit. Like, if you want to get the matching panties, you can get them, but they're $14.95. Also, don't quote stuff that's real, because that just makes you look really stupid. And then everything was like a grin. Like, I'm sorry, do you have a sexy secret?
It's fun. It's fun to have someone around who has a sexy
secret. It's fun to have a sexy secret.
In real life, what would be the best thing about being married to Fred?
Oh, great question. We would have a good time.
I think so, too.
We would make up a lot of pretend songs.
Yeah. We did not discuss this beforehand, but I feel like anytime I do a fake song, if I ever sing, she always does the harmony right away.
Oh, so when you make up a fake song, it's immediately elevated.
Yes. Yeah. Immediately.
And that's... We wrote a fake song called I Love Punk Rock, but it's a very sweet song.
How does I Love Punk Rock go?
I really love punk rock.
I really love it.
It is my favorite. I love punk rock.
I really love it.
That was real. We really did. Yeah. Yeah.
We also wrote a reggae song called Anna Gasteyer.
You wrote a reggae song about our old colleague, Anna Gasteyer.
Yeah, it was like
Anna Gasteyer.
Anna
Gasteyer.
Anna
Gasteyer.
Anna.
Well, you're very prolific.
Yeah.
Hi, Seth.
Oh, Maya. Hi.
I know. It's been so long. How are you doing?
Are you not wearing
pants? I've seen everybody doing that old thing, that old chestnut. I put pants on this morning, so it's not like,
gotcha.
Hold on.
Gotcha.
No pants.
Maya, you look good. I think a lot of people are worried that, you know, those of us aren't keeping it together, but you seem to be doing a really good job.
I'm doing great.
Yeah.
I'm doing great. You know, I mean, I'm doing great. I feel like I really have this thing like locked down now. Like I'm handling it, you know, in the best way possible. And I feel really good. I feel really together. Yeah, things couldn't be better. I've been drinking a lot of celery.
Celery juice, Maya?
I think that's what it is, yeah.
Are you, I think about people like you during times like this, Maya, because you've got four kids living under one roof.
I do have four kids, yeah. And people, you know, people have been asking me a lot, like, how do you do it all? And I'm like, you're looking at it.
Yeah. And so you're not falling to pieces at all?
I mean, you know, some things fall through the cracks. I mean, I'm not a perfect mom, but I brush my teeth, you know.
That's good.
But I think, I think we're incredibly lucky to be healthy. So I feel like that's all that matters, you know.
You have a new animated film on Netflix called The Willoughbys.
Yes.
This is based on a book. Was this a book you read to your kids?
Seth, can you see me, like, I'm seeing myself right now. Can you see, like, below my chin?
Yeah, we're a little bit wider than just your head, yeah.
I'll be right back. I forgot something on the stove.
I do want to jump ahead because you said white lady with dreadlocks. This happens when you leave SNL. Sometimes things will happen in the news. People will say, oh my God, it's such a shame you're not there. And I feel like you have to have been getting this a lot
I've
lately.
Been getting that thing kind of on a daily basis with Rachel
Dolezal. Everybody's saying, like, you could play Rachel Dolezal.
Yeah, I think, like, when Tina, there she blows.
There she blows. There's Dolezal.
Yeah, like, I remember Tina saying, like, when Sarah Palin was happening, everyone kept saying, oh, you got, like, her Dorman's like, you got to do Sarah Palin.
Yeah.
But it happens to me every day. People are like, oh, it's too bad. You haven't been on SNL since 2007.
Yeah.
Like, you have to play this lady. And I got to say, like, it the whole thing is very fascinating.
Well, here's a clip of her getting asked questions by a reporter here in Spokane. I don't know if anyone's seen this, but this is pretty great.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I was wondering if your dad really is an African-American man.
That's a very, I mean, I don't know what you're implying.
Are you African-American?
I don't understand the question of, I did tell you that, yes, that's my dad. And he was unable to come in January.
Are your parents?
Oh. Okay, so. Let's just real quick.
So busted.
Can we give him a taste real quick? I'll be the reporter.
Sure.
Do you indulge all in all?
Yeah, no
okay,
problem.
Great. All right, great.
That's what I'm here for.
Okay, great.
Wait, 1 second.
All right, great. All right, can I just ask you a couple quick questions? Is your father an African American?
Wait.
Sorry, let me make this very simple for you. Are your parents white?
Wait. I don't really understand the question.
Are either of your parents black?
I don't. I mean.
I can see a second. I can see hair coming out from underneath your wig.
This is a really inappropriate question.
Give it up for what we missed.
I think America really missed out.
They really missed out. So President Obama was on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. You're on the same floor.
Yeah,
and so he used
my
your dressing room. And you knew he was going to use your dressing room.
Yeah, he used my dressing room, Seth.
And you left a note.
I did, well, because I knew, first of all, they were like, security's going to be really tight. You can't go down the hall. You're not going to be able to, like, touch your room for 48 hours. And I was like, okay. So I left him a note that just said, hi, President Obama, welcome. And I said, mi casa es su casa. And I said, thanks for the last 8 years. And then he wrote me back. And he said, thanks for letting me crash on your couch.
Wow.
World's coolest president. And you know what else was in my room?
What's that?
Presidential chocolate kisses.
Really?
Yeah.
That you think he just travels with?
Yeah.
Wow.
They're packaged, and they're beautiful, and they say President Obama, and they're chocolate kisses.
Wow.
I keep telling them. Guys, they're chocolate kisses. How cool of a mofo do you have to be like,
I was here. They're chocolate. So good.
Yeah. I wish I'd done that back when I was single.
They might have had to be white chocolate kisses.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I left them with a half a thing of yogurt. Have your kids seen your films?
They have, but I'll be honest, like, I'm a little old-fashioned. Like, Pearl is now 11. She's my oldest. And she complains all the time that all of her friends have seen Bridesmaids except for her. But I feel like, you know, there's some like racy, it's not that, but it's more like language. There's a little bit, like maybe the first scene is a little racy. But like, I mean, she knows what pooping is, which is fine. But I have to say now.
I will say, like, you can know what pooping is and still, if you were her mom, it would be very traumatic to see how you poop in that movie.
You might be right. Yeah. I feel like I'm making a smart choice. Yeah. But then the system failed because then we thought it would be a good idea to show them Austin Powers 1 and 2.
Uh-huh.
So I was, like, hanging out with the kids. Everyone's like, oh, no. But, like, we were hanging out, and someone was talking, and Pearl just, like, brought up a penis pump. I was like, how do you know what a penis pump is? She's like, Austin Powers.
Good job, Mom. That's not a kid's movie.
Nope.
You also filmed Disenchanted.
Yes.
This is you and Amy Adams. You seem to be, there seemed to be a slightly eviler vibe to what you're doing here.
Yeah, this is like the meat and potatoes of character actors. Like, you want to be the evil villain in a Disney movie. It's like everything you could possibly.
Yeah.
It's drag. I'm doing drag. And it was so fun. It was so much fun. I had long nails and I got to be nasty and I got to sing and dance and wear really tight corsets and beautiful gowns. And Amy Adams is
so lovely.
She's the greatest. Plus, she's already a magical human being. And then as Giselle, it was like, it was real. Like, it was like a true princess come to life. But it was so funny because, like, everything about her is so beautiful. It's like walking or hanging out with Cinderella. And so everything about her was like this beautiful white carriage and her horses, and they were so lovely. And I realized I had a carriage too. I had a black carriage, and I had these big, beefy, like, black horses. And my horses peed a lot.
Yeah.
And her horses never peed, and we realized, oh, those are female horses. Mine were male.
Uh-huh.
They had the biggest I've ever seen. And at one point, I have to get out of the carriage and talk to her and greet her, and she goes to curtsy in front of me, and it sounded like someone threw a bucket of water on the ground, and I tried not to look because it was right behind me, and it was going on for a while. I'm like, how many buckets are they? Like, don't they know we're rolling? And we kept going, and then I looked back, and I saw some people like doing like kind of church laughing, but like facing me. The horse was still pissing. It peed for so long. Have you ever seen a horse pee?
I don't think at this level, no.
Wow. Maybe it's because it was an Irish horse. It was very healthy.
Yeah, very healthy. I hope they keep that in. I know that's not very Disney, but I hope they keep that.
It sounds like a Disney thing, right?